How about Lenardi getting over on this? You know, I mean, he's good, but and a good guy, but you know, Lenardi's picks. It's a good thing he's a good guy, and I think he's fair. But there's the Pomeroy. Is that how you pronounce it?
Pomeroy. Yeah.
Pomeroy. And the RPI, the QBS, and the XYZ. So anyway, I think we're all right in all of them. You know? So I don't want to get anybody mad. Anybody, any one of those things that I didn't mention, it wasn't because of, it wasn't to demean that service.
Coach, how do you feel about those services? Do you feel like there should be more human interjection, so to speak?
Well, I hope that, you know, when the committee gets together, there is that. But, I think it shows the popularity of the sport, you know, that many people want to see that many things. And in this day and age where you can see a lot more quickly, that's just going to come about. So I think it's good for the game. And I still would like to see, you know, when you get to the selection, that just like any board, any company, they have advisors, you know, and I'd like to see, after Dean was retired, John Thompson, Bob Knight, you know, for X number of years, an advisory group, because they have a feel for it, you know. You can talk about all these stats, but there's a feel, like, and as much as you all cover the game, and God bless you, you cover a lot of stuff, we have a feel for what we do. You know, we know what it's like, you know, to have, you know, if you're playing Ohio State, Purdue, and Michigan State, three or four games in a row, what that does, and if a team wins three of them, it means more. And you know, it would be good to get that type of advice. I'm not sure you can ever numerically weigh that, you know.
Right.
That's the human factor.
Can I ask one other thing?
Yeah.
If the NCAA follows its guidelines, it's very likely that both you and North Carolina could be in Charlotte in pods.
Yeah.
After 2005, is that something that you welcome or not care about? Or
I don't care. Yeah. We'll go wherever they, you know. I mean, look, if we're playing, I'm used to people cheering against me, you know, and I'm used to people cheering for me. You know, I would never say we lost because of a crowd or where we're put, you know, like, I would think that right now. I mean, both of us have earned that, you know, we should, right? I mean,
yeah, that's why some of the guidelines would say that.
It's kind of hard. You know, depending on where we're supposed to be seated, you know, that's different. Or what regions, you know, we'd be in different regions, you know. But we probably should be there, you know. And, you know, I'd rather be there, you know.
Yeah.
You know, because it's closer and I think it's Friday, Sunday,
it's
too.
Friday, Sunday, yeah.
So if, for the team, you know, if you do go to Sunday in the ACC championship game, it's really a lot better for in either of the two teams, or both of the two teams that play on Sunday, to be given a Friday, Sunday thing.
Can you talk about how you as a coach try to help a shooter break out of a slump? I guess the first thing you probably do is look for mechanical flaws, but if that's not there, what do you do? Is there?
I give them to Chris Collins, and, because I'll tell him something that probably won't work. The main thing I try to tell a kid is, you know, just keep shooting, and you know, like with any of the kids, with all of our kids this week, I've told all of them. I said, look, forget about what's happened, you know, from those 31 games. You know, except the experience. You're all experienced now. You know, everything starts over. You know, we're all 0-0. You're 0-0 from the line. You have no rebounds. You have no points. You know, you get a chance to start over, and we'll do that again. You know, whenever, you know, him the following Friday, you know, because we'll probably play the following Friday, and tell them the same thing going into the NCAA tournament. Don't, you know, because the other thing, you can, if you take, like you've done really well, like you've already accomplished something, you haven't accomplished anything in the postseason. You got to accomplish it all over again. And you got to win again. And if so, I like that part of it. But with the shooting stuff, Chris, Nate, those guys were get extra stuff in, show them on tape, and then shoot your shot. Don't be, as long as you're taking good shots, we're behind you. It's when you take bad shots that we would get on you for. I never fault a guy for missing a shot. Fault him for taking a bad shot.
Mike, on that subject, though, I mean, you were talking about that in Chapel Hill, too, when I think specifically you were asked about Kyle. But in the last six games or so, have you seen anything with his shot that's different? Or
no, he just didn't shot well. Mm-hmm. And, it's such a tough thing, like it's a precise, the precise thing you do in basketball is shoot the ball. And unless you're an inside player, you're powering it. But he's got to just keep at it, last year, there were times where he didn't shoot well, and then all of a sudden he's the MVP of the ACC tournament, or I think he's 0 for 10 against Baylor, and he's the MVP of the Final Four. You know what I mean? He has a track record where his full body of work has produced a number of championships.